Live from Studio 6B in the Fimple Jamont Recreational Center for the Fashionably Exasperated, it's Crane Funkle Live. And now, join us for lots of prank phone calls.
Happy almost 4th of July, folks. Brand Funkles.
Surf's up.
Funkles.
Yeah.
What's up there, squeaky balls? My boys told me to give you a call.
Who's this?
Who the fuck you think it is? This is Frank Rizzo.
Now let's get down to some business before I have to come down here and split a few heads.
Do I know you?
Sure you know me, Chief. We go way back. We used to shoo each other up the ass in the old days. Don't you remember, Ernie? We were good like that.
I knew you in the old days? What, were you with one of the families?
I never went with that family shit, silly ass. You know what I mean? I was the best. I could whack out 100 guys in a week. I ran circles around you.
Well, I don't remember you. Did you go under some other name?
That's right, Chief. They call me Rubberneck.
What the hell does that mean?
I always had a bit of a problem with my temper. People tell me it's a problem because it's always flaring like a pack of hemorrhoids. You know, sometimes it gets on my nerves. I go crazy, kicking guys around, busting heads. You know, I always wind up choking a few people. I'm sick. You know what I mean, Ernie? You fruity-ass bastard.
You want to take it easy with the name calling, particularly since you got a couple of boys on my turf with no protection.
Whoa. Hey there, tough guy. You know, what are you doing? Let's not get out of hand now.
I was just calling to say how much I appreciate the hospitality you showed my boys the other night. You know, they got nothing but good things to say about that happy-ass lackey of yours, Tony Zamboni.
Scarboni,
pepperoni, whatever the fuck you call that little jerk.
He's an okay kid, and you can tell him I said that.
I'll be sure and do that. Now, you want to do me a favor and give me some ideas to what your intentions are here in New York?
What the hell you think, Sizzle Chest? Times are tough. I need dough like anybody else.
So you think you're just gonna waltz in here and start taking over my turf?
You got it there, Liver Lips. I want you, baby.
You sound good. Me and you, we make a team.
You and me make a team. We make a team. I don't know who the fuck you are!
Ernie, what are you trying to get cute with me, baby doll? Come on, what are you trying to make me feel funny in the pants? What's up?
Don't spit up my ass and tell me it's raining out there, tough guy.
You know, this is getting out of line now. I ought to split your nuts from your fucking head to the back of your ass, you got that?
Listen here, shit face! You want to come to New York and have a sit down, that's fine. Just ask me nice. Talk to me like a person. If you start trying to intimidate me, I'm going to get mad.
Ernie, relax, baby. We'll talk about this and that and the other thing when I get into town here, okay? Until then, you deal with my boys, and I'll tell you something. If anything happens to them,
I'm holding you personally responsible.
We got something going here or what?
I'll think about it. I'll take it under advisement.
You're a sweetheart. See you later there, you fucking milky liquor.
R.I.P. Mr. Alan Arkin. From his best performance, his best movie he ever did, The Jerky Boys movie. Yep, he kind of went brutally bleep. Well, we got a bit of an echo, don't we?
No.
Tonight, myself and Mike are coming to you from Mike's house.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Thank you, Mr. Pellet. Alright, should we make the echoing stop?
That'd probably be good best.
Or do we want to just get this out of the way?
Yeah.
Or should we save it for later?
Let's
save it. Okay. Kira, how you doing?
Good. How are you guys?
Pretty good. Pretty good. Pretty good.
It's like, it sounds like men at work or something.
Sounds like meningitis to me.
Jambalaya.
the source material for that?
Lionel Richie.
Beg your pardon?
Lionel Richie.
Okay. Was that All Night Long?
Yes, sir.
Now, what are we eating, Mike?
Apple fritters.
Well, that shares a lot of vowels and consonants with a phrase I'm quite fond of. Apple. But. I like bacon.
Apple dumpling?
Apple butters.
Apple hair?
You can't get me to perjure myself about it. God damn it!
Still apple jacks?
Mustard flavored Skittles rooted 2D fresh and fruity.
This is one of those episodes of Pran Funkles where you might start to think that it's a good idea to empty your mailbox before sending messages to other users. Now, folks, that was an actual message on a voicemail system for a certain college that Patrick and Cody used to fuck around with. It would... I'm transitioning out of Jay Leno here. Mike, did you just make it echo more?
I did. I turned it up a little bit.
Mind the gap.
Oh,
mind
shit.
The gap. Mind the gap.
That's the sound of a man who didn't. Mind the gap. Terribly sorry. What was I talking about? I had somewhere I was going. What was that, Kira?
I don't remember.
I'm sorry.
Kira, how you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Do we need to make the...
Why are you not echoing?
Because I'm not over there.
Well,
get that done.
Get that going.
Okay.
We need to make this stop.
How long of a drive is it? I'll get there like right at the end of the show.
Yeah, it's about a 12-hour drive. Give or take. What was I talking about? I had somewhere I was going.
Finish the fucking story.
When I listen back, I'll know, but yeah.
Well, you guys see the avatar in the chat?
Oh, we've... Where is it echo?
Is it on the big screen over there?
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, is it full screen?
Not full screen.
But it's...
Let's talk like this.
It's big enough.
Okay. We're not echoing now.
Right.
Can we get a Zelda victory song?
Possibly. Well...
There is something that happens when you have that echoing effect that's like, it is fun, but not necessarily for other people. So we've been staring at Mr. Petty.
Okay, well, this is what happened. This is about a minute long, so just look at it and listen to the...
Did you look at it?
Thank you. The end.
Now, Cody had to step away and he missed the very best part.
Which part?
I think
Okay, I'll that's when he stepped away?
Yeah, he missed that.
Okay, I'll play it when he gets back.
Why is his mouth so hairy?
Ew! Let me bring it up on full screen here. Oh! Yeah, what's hair on his teeth, like growing out of his teeth? Yeah, he's like a bear or something on the left. It's just all like, I don't know, it's all fucked up. Well, that was the sound of what this is, and what it is Tom Petty singing while eating oatmeal. Because when I slowed that down, that's what I thought it sounded like, and I wanted to make it more psychedelic, so I did that thing just now. Or earlier, actually.
What is the yellow thing on the right-hand side?
A leaf rolled up, like a... the rind of a lemon without the lemon in it.
Yeah, that's a mess.
And like the bottom right face is like Kurt Cobain, kind of. It's just really freaky. With like a hairy tongue. Cody, you didn't hear all that?
I did not.
Okay, listen to this. Listen to the end part here.
The end.
Whoops, not that.
I heard, and now I'm not listening.
Don't dip your beard hair in my cereal no more.
I've been staring at Mr. Petty's beard draping into
Cody, listen, we're playing it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. I'll shut up.
The end.
Okay. Well, I think I understand, but just in case, can someone fill me in? Can someone Phil Collins me in?
At the end of the music video for that song, Tom Petty eats Alice, and then he burps. And that's the burp.
Okay. Well... the only problem I have with that is, I was under the impression that Alice would not be seen tonight. Oh. I was a bit upset about it, and I'm just, you're fucking with my emotions here, okay?
Wait, that was a lie, right? They didn't really move the...
I hoped it would be, but...
You gotta tell me that's
please
a lie.
Don't make me relive. I don't want to relive this.
That's gotta be a lie. I don't know. Let's check. I have the tape, so I mean.
Oh, God.
Actually, no, I mean, it's on.
I'm standing up. I'm gonna want to. Wait, hang on. Okay, I'm gonna want to stand up for this. Okay, here we go.
Okay, we're gonna watch Alice and.
Hey, Mike. Hang on, Mike. Can you zip tie me to the outlet? Okay, thank you. All right, here we go.
All right, we got 5 seconds before Alice comes on. Okay, and let's turn on the TV. And...
Alice, starring Linda Lavin, will return next Sunday evening, but 1 hour later than usual at 9:30, 8:30 Central and Mountain Time.
Oh, no! Oh, no!
How was that?
Pretty good.
No. Oh, no.
I didn't have the bravado, but I think I captured the essence. What do you guys think?
It's pretty good.
I think that in this picture, at the bottom middle, there's like a phone, and then it has berries and oatmeal on top of it. Like, can you see it? Like an upside down phone, like the 80s office phone, or like a high heeled shoe, maybe. Damn.
Alright. Sorry, folks.
Nah, nothing. Nothing to be sorry about. You wanna make a call?
Well, I'm here. I think we mentioned. I'm in the same room as Mike. Which does not happen very often. I think it might not have happened in the last year.
Been too long?
Last time this happened, some crazy shit happened. Yeah, that was a verwampy. So far, nothing.
Hi, Fred. Satisfied?
Kira, how's that sound? Are we getting any feedback?
That's good, but...
Mind the gap.
Carl.
Is it too early for him to be listening?
Yeah.
Well, if you see him in the chat, tell me and I'll play that.
Mike, yeah. Are you taking a look at the chat tonight?
Yes. That's,
I ask knowing that you're not. Because I'm sitting right next to you and taking a look at the same things you're taking a look at.
It's right there.
Little fella.
It's on this system.
All right. Mike, just let me know that I was incorrect about what was going on. Okay. We have five screens in front of us, and I am not exaggerating.
I'm going to take a picture for.
To be fair, two of those are the same one. One of them is just plugged into the large television screen. So we have four necessary screens in front of us. Well, thanks for tuning in to Pranfunkles. This is, of course, it's our 4th of July special episode of Pranfunkles. We're celebrating that one Will Smith movie where he wore those one glasses.
Oh, Men in Black.
And that one, Vincent D'Onofrio played the part of that one Private Pyle who blew off that one Private Pyle's head. And Gunnery Sergeant, what was his name?
Hartman.
Hartman's latrine, yes.
Holy thank you. Jesus! What is that?
A jelly donut.
Yes.
I don't know where I'm going with all this, but...
You guys are high as fuck.
Kira, are you?
Yes.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Oh, I'm looking at the chat. Oh, wow. Dang. That's a big soundboard.
What's going on? Oh, yeah, okay. Mike sent a picture to Kira.
Damn.
Of the setup that we have going here.
Wow.
How old I look in the picture. Ladies and gentlemen, George Carlin. Three. But that's fine. I'm happy you look like that.
Like your soundboard is like a freaking poster on the wall.
Makes it a little easier to see.
Oh my god, yeah. And is it, like, taller so you can fit more on the screen?
Nah, it's still the same ratio.
Oh, that's too bad.
It's just a projection of the screen on the computer monitor that you can clearly see in the background. Thank you very much.
This trip to 1999 brought to you by Kira.
99.
99. Adra.
100.
99.
90.
99, are you out of your mind?
99.
All right, am I in the driver's seat?
99. 999. Water. 99.
99. 999. 99. Flavored skin 3D2D fresh and fruity. Mustard flavored skin 3D2D fresh and fruity. 999.
Mustard flavored Skittles rooted 2D fresh and fruity.
Alright, should I make a call?
Yes.
Okay.
Unless there's some other
good times.
Shriner meeting, Lions Club, old grandpa's meeting at a building in a small town thing that we should cover before we get to the calls.
Mr. Explorer update?
Yes. There is a very brief and interesting Mr. Explorer update, but nonetheless, as I put in our Facebook chat, update, I think he finally sold his house and moved out, because there are no flags whatsoever for any country, religious, or political belief flying. There are no vehicles or construction equipment or farm or, you know, tractors. There's no Bobcat Goldthwaites for sale in his yard.
Oh, well, hold on. Let me guess. You got a wheelchair for sale. I'm supposed to have a wheelchair for sale. And
now, Mike.
Flag in the front yard that says, don't tread on me. And you want to have one of those in your house, too, brother, but you can't fly it. And
go fuck yourself.
Fucking bullshit, motherfucker. Go fuck yourself.
Mike pressed the button and then got up and walked away and got something out of the kitchen.
Adjust the temperature at the thermostat.
Yeah, that was a pimp move. Anyway, yeah. What was I talking about? Should I just shut up?
Mr. Explorer?
Oh, yes. Yeah. So, yeah, I think he actually... The update is I think he actually moved, because this whole time there was always something for sale in his yard, and now it's like, it's just a boring old yard.
Oh my god.
Oh my yard. It's just got grass and no vehicles and no construction or farm equipment for sale in it, and no signs that say for sale, that it's confusing as to whether they're selling the house or the object that the sign's leaning against. So yeah, I think maybe he finally sold his house, because my point is, we should definitely call him tonight.
Okay.
And maybe for the last time, until we call him again several times. And I'll shut up. Mike! Kira?
Yeah?
You're both at the Hellman's Mayonnaise.
Yeah. Oh, we better bring out some people then.
I would disagree.
Well, that month has come and gone.
Nah, think again, man. It's always pride. Wait, what am I looking
at? It is on Pran Funkles. Who's playing Day of the Tentacle?
No, think again, man.
Earthworm Jim.
No. Certain royalty gentleman.
A leisure suit Larry?
No. Royalty.
Penny from Inspector Gadget?
No, like would be in a royal family.
Linda's orange chocolate balls, Timothy.
A certain prince. And he's from Prince of something.
Persia?
Yep. It's when
Is
he
that
beat,
the correct
yes,
answer?
It's when he beat the last boss.
Oh, I never did that.
Oh.
That game, it was difficult, so I turned it off and returned it to Blockbuster Video instantly, because that's what you do.
I only played it on the computer at school.
Yeah.
Where did you play it?
At home on my computer, but first at school. Then I copied it. I copied that floppy.
Oh shit!
Oh god, we're in trouble.
Let's edit that out.
Yeah.
Did I hear you right? Did I hear you saying that you're gonna make a copy of a game without paying?
Yeah.
Come on, guys. I thought you knew better. Don't copy that floppy.
Okay, here, I'll just stomp on it. Sorry. It's already in my computer anyway, dickhead. It's on my hard drive. What?
You're almost waking up the animals around here.
Oh.
Try harder.
You were making their ears twitch when you were playing that?
All of them. Okay.
Oh.
Well, wait a minute. Who the heck are you anyway?
Yeah, and what are you doing on my computer?
I'm your MC, Double Dev, DP, that's the disc protector for you and the posse. That's the artists, writers, designers, and programmers that work up the images for games and grammar.
Alright, one animal is definitely awake and extremely annoyed by what you're playing here.
Okay, I won't torture your animal.
But, to be fair, there are several animals in this room right now.
Some of them like it?
I just now realized, you got a lot of animals, Mike.
I do have a lot. Too many puppies.
Too many cooks.
Oh, Primus sucks, man. Yeah, John needs to make a comeback and do like a Primus, like, my name is Mud or something. That would be so fucking funny. To see John do that song?
That would be great.
You can just kill me right there. That's all I need to see.
Who's John?
Karaoke.
Oh, I thought there was like a John that was a member of
Primus
or something, yeah.
Man, Jimmy, then mommy, you son of a
bitch. Uh-oh.
Yeah, I was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine. I never understood a single word he said to help me drink his wine.
Jeremiah was a bullfrog.
That sounds better than John, actually.
Was he? Bye.
No,
MBE. tons.
Sorry.
That's okay.
But you have made more than 3 errors.
Let's make a call.
Alright, sorry. Yeah. I might have gotten a little bit affected by something.
Okay, this is who we're calling. I think you want somebody to do soundboard, right?
Whack at.
Look at the chat.
Oh, yes. This is whatever. Yeah.
Okay. This is somebody who called somebody we know.
You know.
And got a
someone
soundboard?
Keeps saying I'm insane to complain about a shotgun wedding. Staying on my shirt. Scientology is the thing you should do.
Call him up.
Call me.
Okay, here we go.
Thank you for calling the fundraising center. We are unable to take your call at this time.
Fresno?
For more options, please press 9.
Okay, there's...
As always in life, if you'd like more options for whatever situation you're in currently, just press 9. Hypothetically, or... Literally.
Okay, I'll do that. You see the next one?
Yeah, this is a phone number that I believe it's a sign that I saw on the side of the road.
And for this Jack Arnold. Wants some of them.
Some of them fucking bricks! Son of a bitch.
Mario keeps punching him.
Them goddamn flowers and mushrooms keep fucking popping up.
What's that little star that bounced by your house last week?
Yeah. What was that?
A pickup, hang up. Let's call that. Anonymous.
It's another prank call. Pick up, hang up. Pick up, hang up. Pick up, hang up. Are you getting any feedback?
No.
If you quit working after only 4 hours, you'd probably get fired, right? Right. That's
fine. I don't know. Give me a minute. What? I beg your pardon? Oh. Celery salt, honey. The piping on my vinegar really took a dive.
I don't know what. Try one more time.
Tinsels are on my pizza.
Mr. Explorer.
It was very loud here.
I gotcha.
But you know, Mr. Explorer, just because you sold your house doesn't mean you don't still have the same phone number.
Just walk from there. I'm either on or away from my phone.
Apple, bud. I would like an apple flavored Skittle, please. Yeah, they're fucking idiots.
Lime's better.
Well, there's already a lemon
scale. I'm either on or away from home. Please give me a call back. Thank you.
Don't like the...
At the tone, please...
It sounds like you haven't listened to Mr. Carolla.
When you have finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
So you don't know
to how... To me, I feel like you can get green apple on everything.
But the best green apple is in Skittles.
Hmm.
Especially the sour ones.
Better than the Jolly Rancher?
It's about
green
the same.
Apple?
This guy keeps boasting about his toaster.
Boasting about his toaster.
Mind the gap. Mind the gap.
I think lime's better.
Fuck you. That was all right.
If you are satisfied with your message, press message review.
You don't know how.
I feel like you can get green apple on everything.
But the best green apple is in Skittles. Especially the sour ones.
Better than the Jolly Rancher?
It's about
green
the
apple?
This guy keeps boasting about his toaster.
Mind the gap. Mind the gap.
I think lime's better.
Fuck you. That was all right.
If you are satisfied with your message, press 1 to listen to your message.
Is that the Sega Genesis Street Fighter 2 or something?
Ah, different system, man.
DOS?
No.
I should know that, because I had that. And the audio is fucking horrible.
On DOS?
Yeah, Street Fighter 2 for DOS. I've brought it up before. What?
I've seen it, but I never played it.
Am I eating this, Mike?
Yes.
Mike is putting something in my hand and instructing me to eat it.
Eat that.
Mushrooms?
Nah.
We wouldn't catch you off guard like that.
Sure. I know.
A lot more celebration.
And the rules clearly state in the bylaws of Pranfunkles, the mushroom episode shall contain... Mike... Cody, Kira, and Patrick, and if possible, Justin, and if possible, Miles, and if possible, Carl. Are you still there, Kira?
And if possible.
And if possible.
Tom Petty.
Other Carl. And if possible, last but not least, a certain fella that we love a lot. Wait, what is this ball I'm putting in my mouth, Mike?
From what I've been told, they're freeze-dried Tootsie Rolls.
And these, Now, I'm guessing by the iridescent quality of the plastic Ziploc pouch that these balls were in, that this is a THC type of substance that you obtained via a local establishment.
That's neither here nor there.
Okay. I think it's there. Now, here's where I'm going to agree with you. I think it's neither here.
Neither here.
Here's where I'm going to disagree. I do think it is there. Kira, what do you think?
I just can't imagine a world without Wilers.
Stop the world, I want a Wilers!
Whoa, 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 whoa! Uh-oh.
Uh-oh, what happened?
Did you hear that? Oh, shit. Am I wasting $1,000 worth of...
No, just snort it.
Okay, I'm going to snort it, folks. In actuality, I'm licking this stuff off my hand and my fingers. Pram, licking fingers.
Have fun with that. Take it.
What is this?
It's just that. It's just...
Okay, it's LSD, and I'm... It's in a...
It's just a Tootsie Roll.
I mean, if it is, I would prefer to just eat a Tootsie Roll.
Yeah.
As opposed to all this drama.
Well, you're not supposed to do that to it.
I'm not supposed to smash it in a violent rage while I'm...
You were just supposed to eat it. You weren't
very,
supposed to, like,
I'm speaking
for 10 minutes
into a microphone and getting very animated about
shit.
What I'm doing.
Now you just... Right. Now you fucked it up.
Okay, so what... Tell me what to do. You're so...
I need another moose. I need another moose. I need another moose.
All right, let's make a call.
Oh, that tastes like a Whopper. That tastes like what...
Hello, and thanks for calling to order Shampoo, the fastest way to dry your car. To ensure
has gone fishing, and he's hauling in a Whopper.
Hello, and thanks for calling to order Shampoo, the fastest way to dry your car. To ensure the best customer service,
water.
This call may be recorded. If you're calling to place an order and get free shipping,
water.
Say order or...
What's in this?
I'm sorry I missed your response. You've reached the Shampoo order line. If you are calling to place an order, press 1 now. To learn the status of an order you have already placed, please press 2. For more information about Shampoo before placing your order, please press 3.
Mind the gap.
I'm sorry I missed your response. You've reached the Shampoo order line. If you are calling to place an order, press 1 now. To learn the status of an order you have already placed,
please
press 2. For more information about
Shampoo. I'm sorry. Kira? All right.
We have...
I can explain what just happened if you want to hear it.
Okay.
Maybe the audience deserves to hear. It was like a malted milk ball, candy type of... It was like a crunchy thing. And I was very animated, and Mike was waiting to see me. Now I'm questioning again. I guess he's brought out another pouch. But I thought this was some... THC infused thing, and I was like, I accidentally like crushed it and it went to powder and fell on the floor, and I'm like, oh, was that $100 down the drain?
Oh god.
And
is
then
it okay?
he assured me that this was just
candy.
It was just okay.
Fruit dry. Yeah.
It was like a malted milk ball.
It was
a puffy freeze dried
candy.
But now he's got another pouch of something else. Now, is this THC infused?
Absolutely.
It's not?
Absolutely
okay.
Not.
All right. Well, let's move on with
let's
the show.
Let's just move on. Yeah, it's just candy.
Sorry about that, folks.
Driving like an asshole.
Do you want to talk about your experience with said a-hole?
Yeah, this is, okay, so, you know how when you're driving down the street and there's like a turn lane that you want to get into and you put on your signal and, you try to get into that lane, and then some fucking asshole that... You know, it's one of two things. they don't see your signal because they're a fucking asshole and they cut you off, or they see it, and I think this is more likely, and in this case I think it is what happened. They see it and they're like way behind you, but then they speed up to cut you off, like, oh no you don't, or oh no you ain't.
You're
playing pole position. So this guy did this to me in the most asshole way possible. Like, the speed limit was like 35, and I was doing about that, and like, I'm like, oh, I need to get over to the right. And he's doing like fucking, you know, he's probably doing, a, you know, 40, and like, I put my signal on and he fucking sped up. Like, it was, there was no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
You weren't getting in.
But anyway, I'm like, oh, I hope this motherfucker has, you know, hope this is a company truck, and I hope they have, and then they had a phone number, and it's like, we care about safety with our drivers, and yeah. So that's who we're going to call.
Well, maybe they care, but that guy did not.
Oh, and I also, like, you know, because I had to stop at the stoplight and, like, look at him next to me. So I, like, stared at him and just, like, looked straight forward, you know. So, not, you know, not acknowledging it. So I don't know if he's just an asshole who doesn't pay attention to other cars on the road, or if he's an asshole who purposely stared forward.
Or a coward.
We've all had this kind of scenario, but
yeah,
it happened, and it was a company vehicle with like a how's my driving thing.
Ironic.
And I'm a guy who has a how's my prank calling show. And in the case of tonight's episode, it's we wish some of that would happen.
Let's call.
It's nice to know that in 2023, there's still some prank calling out there.
I think Bertha has eats a lot of that.
No, I don't. It's too healthy. When did my mother walk out of go?
Okay, I guess they don't answer on weekends, but they answered in the middle of the night. On like a Wednesday or something. Oh well.
That's a situation where, Kira, if you don't mind, I think you have a, and I apologize for bringing it up on the show, but you have a daytime number list.
Yes.
Do you have a running?
Oh yeah.
Does that, have you added that?
No, but I will right now.
I'm going to say it's they're very deserving based on how their piece of shit driver is.
I'm trying to find it. I don't know. I'll just make a note and do it later.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Butt lobster.
Larry.
Butt lobster.
Well, we know what you like.
What's it called?
In your
please.
Mr. Peter Gabriel.
Not me.
Ah. Peter Gabriel. Kira, are you there? Well, we got a bit of a situation.
Pot and horny guys.
Not feeling so good. Listen to Chuck FM.
Should we call Patrick? He might be. He might have to get up and go to work tomorrow. What was that?
I think you said he did.
Are we good?
Yeah, that's some kind of update.
Mike had a bit of a hot and horny update on his computer.
I think about his word. My microchips all go insane.
Each time I think. About his word.
Yes.
My microchips all go.
Yeah. Okay.
Absurd. Phil Stiller. Phil Stiller eating pecans.
Stupid bitch.
Phil Stiller eating pecans.
What kind of potatoes?
Phil Stiller eating pecans.
How you doing, Mike?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, Mike. How are you doing?
I'm doing great.
I'm doing pretty... Wait, did you ask how I was... I don't think you asked.
I think I did.
No, I don't think you did.
I asked you once. I'll ask you
again. I'm telling you... How are you doing? And I'm asking you, I'm doing pretty good.
I'm doing good.
I hope I'm not doing too good myself. What is this?
It's that apple fritter.
Is this a mysterious dessert?
More food.
Something you might...
That's what happens.
You might eat.
Yeah.
And it's a dessert type of thing, and it might contain a certain amount
of
sugar.
Hallucinogenics.
Oh, are there hallucinogenics in it?
No.
Oh, okay.
Not
it just
that one.
It just came from Whataburger?
No.
Oh, okay. Sorry, folks. This. We thought you were going to hear us hallucinate, but instead you're just,
You get nothing.
No, there's something.
Yeah.
Hey, hang on.
You're going to listen to us call voicemails?
I thought, wait, I heard...
And not hallucinate.
I heard something. Hang on. Shh, 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 shh. What was that?
I heard that.
What was that? That was something.
You're hearing shit.
Pancake. Sausage.
Okay.
Heard it.
Well, who's in the chat, Mike?
I've got here for the comments.
Love you a lot.
Love you, Colin. Yeah. Andy Eccentric.
Love you a lot.
Robert Chandler. He's here.
Love you a lot.
BRB.
Love you a lot.
That's about it.
Batwider.
Lionheart was here earlier. He or she bailed.
Batwider.
Or whatever. Bald Bull Shannon.
Batwider.
Here for the comments!
Chuck FM! Oh, boy. Well, Pranfunkles, thanks for listening. How long have we been on the air? And by air, I mean the space between Peter Dinklage's nutsack. Mister. What's that guy's name? Dave Matthews. That's who I was trying to think of. All right.
This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
We're going to make a Pranfunkle here. Just bear with me.
Yeah. What's going on? How you doing?
I'll tell you how I'm doing.
Well, so we have a situation going on.
Yes.
Somebody outside my door
is doing what?
Holding a boombox on their shoulder.
Yeah, are they reenacting that scene from that movie that this guy ain't never seen?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sorry. How'd you like to call that? Go on.
I'm
sorry.
I've seen it.
What were you saying?
I don't know.
What's going on out there?
I don't know. You heard it. You're here too. What'd you hear?
I heard.
Let's find out.
And now, on with the countdown. Mike's looking outside. Nothing?
I see a duck.
Okay. I'm getting up. I'll be right back. You can hear us in the background. Pranfunkles, you want to? Well, we're back. We heard some racket out in the front yard.
Ran them off.
And to be honest, I thought you'd hear more fireworks in the background tonight on Pranfunkles, but
yeah, they shut down. Then they were a lot earlier.
This is one of those areas you can hear a lot of people lighting off fireworks, but only until a certain point in the evening, and then the police don't allow that shit.
That's right.
Would you like to call that phone?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to need you to look up an area code.
All right.
And I'm also going to need you to tell me what that says.
Right. Yeah.
Okay, I made a note. I took... all right, let me mute just for a second, folks. And then that?
Yeah.
Okay. If you can Google that real quick, Mike. Took a picture of a phone in a very random place. And it's an old phone, and it has an old phone number written on it. We're going to call that number and see what happens. Wait, where's your... apple butter. Wait, where's... Can I see where you're... Where are you typing? Oh, okay, up there. Yeah. Right. Several different...
That's what I'm thinking.
Mike's got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 monitors to his computer.
That's what I'm thinking. What do you think?
The last digit...
Could go,
I think is this.
Okay. Could be.
And I took... This is a little behind the scenes. This is how the sausage is fucked on Pranfunkles. With a vagina. I took this picture and then I looked at it on my phone to make sure, because I was standing there next to where I took the picture. And just so I would remember. And I made a mental note that it is what it looked like at first glance. So I think...
So that is the first number you thought.
Yes. But if this doesn't work, we definitely should try that other number.
So that's what we're looking at.
Yes. All
right.
So
if you see over here, though...
I'm going to...
Right here? If you see right here?
Huh.
So there might be that, I guess, too.
No, that would make sense, yeah.
Okay. So it could be the one.
We could try the other one.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's possibly 4 different numbers to call here. Let's try this one first. And can you keep track?
Yeah. Folks, how you doing?
We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected or is no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording in error, please check the number and try your call again. We're sorry, you...
So I'd say
that's the most common disconnected message that I'm sure Mike, as well as me, and a lot of people listening are familiar with. Like, I'm so used to hanging up on that... I almost hung up as soon as I heard it say "we're," but then I was like, "Well, it's Pranfunkles. Let's listen to it."
So I'd say that one next.
Okay.
Let's try that. Maybe we had the first 3 digits wrong.
All right, let's try this. That was an instant audible. Instant audible, and then a double audible. Should I try it again?
Yeah, give it one more shot.
Uh-oh. I'm going to have to retype it. Or, yeah. No, I don't have to. I'll click this. That's it, right?
Looks like it.
That's an instant audible. And a repeat.
So let's change this digit to that digit. How you doing, folks? Here for the comments. How you doing?
That's also, all right. Now what's our...
All right, we got one more left. It's gonna
one more option.
There we go.
Okay, here we go.
This is going to be it.
We're sorry, you have reached a number that has been disconnected
or is no longer in service. Wow. If you feel you've reached the recording an error, play
the number and try your call again.
That was a
I'll say.
I'd say.
She was very busty.
Yeah.
All right. Do I want to do a soundboard on this one? Or?
Yeah.
All right, I got a number. I think we have two different numbers to try on this one, but this is a I'm gonna say this is a straight up asshole. Someone gave me an individual to try to dial, and I've got a couple of different numbers to try, so. Let's
fuck
see.
You, asshole!
See if we can get him.
Go
to
fuck answer. Yourself!
Fuck you, you asshole!
Well,
did he say hello, or was that a voicemail or answering machine? Should I? You want me to call back?
I heard him say hello. I thought.
Oh shit!
Call him back.
Well, I was like hanging up, and then I heard it and couldn't. Yeah, didn't. Okay, I'm gonna try it again.
Yeah.
Hello? Yeah.
I'm returning your phone call.
I'm not returning my phone call.
This is the second time this has happened to me.
Well, get the fuck out of here.
Fucking bullshit.
All right. Well, let's go. Let's give him a call back.
Hello?
Well, you missed me, but it happened.
I've gotten 5 calls from you.
All right. Kira, are you there?
Yeah.
All right.
Let's call. Do you want to call somebody else?
Yeah.
Okay. The inventor of gravy soup.
I believe I know the name of this person. Mrs. Bertha J. Gravington.
Please leave your message for 8.
Oh, I have a Borden for you, honey. I have 14 Borden numbers. How are you doing?
Hello?
I have some Borden numbers for you to mess with, honey. Have you seen that new Wild Wild West movie?
Dumbass back.
Who is this?
Inventor of gravy soup.
When you go into my gravy soup. And they do have gravy in my voice. And my gonna go.
Please leave your message.
And sending them in. Belgian waffles at McDonald's, you son of a bitch.
Well, if it's not a Stephen J. Cannell production, I'm not interested.
In your typewriter.
To replay your message, press 1.
And sending them in. Belgian waffles at McDonald's, you son of a bitch.
Well, if it's not a Stephen J. Cannell production, I'm not interested.
Back in your tub, right? That's where I think.
To replay your message.
Well, we clearly heard a gentleman falling off the side of a Grandy's restaurant.
Yeah, he got drunk and climbed up there and fell off.
You know, if they didn't want you climbing on the top of a Burger King, why the fuck do they have a ladder? That's right there in the drive-thru. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But like,
you know what I mean, Vern? Okay.
The just trying to make a living guy.
this motherfucker.
Did you enjoy that?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, last week's episode that I was not on, I listened back and just loved the shit out of it. And that's, we were talking about this over here at Mike's when we were very slowly setting up. Just the, you know, we need that, we need some kind of fucked up effect or echoing on every episode, you know, because it makes it that much better. Because, you know, Patrick had his own squeaky the chair.
Yeah.
And now it seems like we intentionally did that shit, but I promise we didn't.
Nah. Long-time listeners will know what's happening.
Long-time listener, first-time masturbator.
Saucy.
With video games off. But not the virtual ones.
Hopefully we get that guy who's hard working and wants you to know about it.
Yes.
Hello. Thank you for calling to order Smile Actives, the simplest and easiest. For quality purposes, your call may be monitored or recorded.
Thank you for calling Smile Actives, the easiest teeth whitening system for a whiter, brighter smile today. We're confident that you'll love the results you see with Smile Actives, and we're excited to help you get started on your smile journey. Please hold, and an agent will be with you momentarily.
What was that?
It's another prank call.
Pick a hangout. Pick a hangout. Pick a hangout.
Different number.
A bit of a Bumbleton.
Hello, thank you for calling.
For quality purposes, your call may be monitored or recorded. Thank you for calling Smile Actives, the easiest teeth whitening system for a whiter, brighter smile today. We're confident that you'll love the results you see with Smile Actives.
We're confident in the comedians that are going to jam into your car while you're getting coffee.
And an agent will be with you momentarily.
Hi, thank you for calling to order Smile Actives. My name is Stephanie. May I please have your name?
Hello.
Hi. Hello, my name is Stephanie, and thank you for calling us Smile Actives. May I please have your name?
My name is Seal. May I have your name, please?
Hi, Seal. Thank you. I'm sorry?
May I have your name, please?
Yes, my name is Stephanie.
May I have your zip code, please?
We are in Portland, Maine.
Okay. I see.
Yes, ma'am. May I please have your zip code?
57078.
All right. I appreciate it. So,
I beg your pardon?
Today is your lucky day. I'm sorry?
I beg your pardon?
Oh, no. I'm just going to give you the information about the offer.
I interrupted you.
It's okay. No problem.
May I have your address now, please?
I need to ask you, why do you need my address?
Please. Is there an apartment or a unit number at this location?
Ma'am, this is an order line. I can help you to process an order.
Okay.
But I'm not calling. I don't give any call to order. I can help to order.
I didn't quite understand what you were talking about, a pneumatic tube.
I'm sorry?
I didn't quite understand what you were talking about, a pneumatic tube.
No, but I mentioned, are you calling to place an order, or are...
Yes.
Okay, so you're calling to place an order with us, right? With the Smile Active.
Please.
Okay. Okay, I can help you to process the order. As I mentioned, we have the special buy one, get one free promotion. And when you order today, you will receive a 1 ounce supply of the new Smile Active Pro Wine In Gel with 33% greater wine in power versus the original formula. It's just for $24.95. You will get the second one for free.
Okay.
We're also including including free shipping and handling and a 60-day money-back guarantee.
Phil Collins, sweetie.
Something about Billy Joel?
I'm sorry?
Something about Billy Joel?
Billy Joel.
Okay.
Pencil.
All right, ma'am, you're calling to Smile Active. Is the rye product that you wanted to order?
Yes. Something about Billy Joel?
I'm sorry?
Are you in Allen, South Dakota?
No. No, ma'am.
My aunt's like, aren't we all in Allen, South
Dakota? True. Handling. This call may be recorded.
Ma'am, this is not any line for Billy Joel. Actually, it's for Smile Active to help you to widen your teeth.
I would like a Smile Active for Billy Joel.
Thank you very much.
I'm sorry, but please stop playing with the line. This is a serious line. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
After that?
Sorry, folks. Tell her about it, folks. This is a serious line. Pran Funkles has discovered another serious line. Kira, what do you think about that? So, Billy Joel is one of those people that, he's got some songs that I love, and then he has some songs that I fucking hate, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, thanks for reminding me. Tell Her About It. That's a horrible fucking song.
That's one you don't like.
Well, actually, to be fair, there are a lot of songs that I hate just because I've heard them too many times. That's probably one of them. And, you know.
That's
So totally, if we're going to, if it's going to be a sliding scale of how many times you've heard it versus would you just hate it the first time you heard it? Two different things, man. You know
right.
what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
How many songs do you fucking hate because you've heard them so many times? Because a prime example, Kira, are you back?
Yeah.
One of them that I've noticed, and I started noticing this, you know, more than 10 years ago, probably, but if I was sitting at a bar and they had their Teacher Lady Kiss FM playlist or whatever, but Under Pressure, and it would either be that or Vanilla Ice, and either way, some fucking douchebag that was sitting at the bar would be like, "Oh, did you know that they sampled that?" Or, you know, if it if it was Under Pressure, the, "Did you know that that's Freddie Mercury? Did you know that's David Bowie?" So, but it's also, it's the, it's kind of the follow-up to your Don't Stop Believing, when, you know, that was on the ending of The Sopranos, and then you would hear that song constantly. And kind of around that time, you would hear Under Pressure. And now it's like, every time I go in a grocery store or a restaurant where they have, you know, the background music, I hear Under Pressure every fucking time.
Constantly.
So that's why I fucking hate that song now.
Yeah. Well, I never liked it anyway, so...
I didn't either, but I didn't like it before I had it, heard it under that context, so... Tell her about it.
Tell her all about it.
Pen. Gillette. And...
Gracias por llamar a Ayuda Legal. Alguien tomará su llamada en un momento. Esta llamada será grabada por propósitos de calidad.
Let's make a pranfunkle to someone who might actually answer the phone. How long have we been on the air?
That I don't know.
Kira?
About 90 minutes?
About 90 seconds!
No.
I'm leaning up against this bus here, goddammit. The director of photography probably shouldn't have made it look so awkward. But I'm leaning against a goddamn school bus.
Thank you for calling. Press 7 to continue.
Cut. Continue doubling.
Gracias por llamar a Ayuda Legal. Alguien tomará su llamada en un momento. Esta llamada será grabada por propósitos de calidad.
Got in there. Planner's brand cheese balls. Okay. Hello. Well, it sounded like David Leavenworth forgotten his menstrual cycle.
It's called the Hulk Hogan Enthusiast.
Mr. Hulkington J. Hulkington.
Marla.
parcel, honey.
You have reached 377.
Apples! Morris's Carl office. Marley Matlin's. Adamus.
You have reached 377.
Medicine Man is a good movie starring Sean Connery, honey. I believe Lorraine Bracco is in it, too. Not that I've ever watched a movie.
Thank you for calling in for legal help. Someone will be with you in just a moment. This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
You're welcome, and I'm also flipping on my lips while I'm talking.
Oh, you're underwater, basically.
I'm under pressure.
Oh, we got hung up on, folks. I'll shut up.
Either that or there's something wrong with Google Voice tonight.
Thank you for calling in for legal help. Someone will be with you in just a moment. This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
This call may be recorded.
Mike's falling asleep at the wheel here.
This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
Hello.
And actually, who is calling?
Hello?
Hi, this is Dudley Hall.
Hi, my name is Carlos. I'm with the Legal Help Center. Are you calling in regards to an injury matter?
Yes, I think that we were disconnected.
Okay, I'm not sure because I know I wasn't speaking to you, but how far did you get in that conversation?
Please grab a pen and paper to take some notes.
I'm sorry?
Because you called me, I have to actually get your information up on the computer here. Please
okay.
grab a pen and
you
paper.
Said that, take you some said notes. That you got disconnected, so were you calling for an injury?
That's all. That's all.
Yeah, call me back when you know.
Thank you for calling in for legal help. Someone will be with you in just a moment. This call may be recorded for quality assurance.
You want me to do it?
No, I don't mind. I'll carry the one.
Always the same. It's just a shame that I'm sorry. I probably should have been muted. Pont, 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 pont. Though my heart would tell me so. Kira, you there?
Mm-hmm.
It's always a shame. It's just the same. Or, it's always the same, and it's just a shame. What do you think?
Well, what does Dudley think?
That's a bit of a catch-22. Because Dudley does not think. Know what I mean, Vern?
Yeah.
Tell me it's black when you know that it's white. Taking it all instead of taking one bite. Living with you is just a, putting me through it all of the time.
It's called a shrimp platter.
The service you're attempting to use has been restricted or is unavailable. Please contact customer care for assistance. Message ME401RI65.
All right, 65. Contact that too. All right.
The service you're attempting to use has been restricted or is unavailable. Please contact customer care for assistance. Message NY201NY65.
Thank you, someone from a Judd Apatow film or TV series. Tell him it's black when you know it's that's white.
Is everybody awake now?
This is your Phil Collins wake up call. That's all. That's all. Wow.
Who is around you? Is anybody asleep?
Not anymore.
Your call may be recorded. Please press 1 to speak with a live representative.
A man's like a simple kind of man. There's no need to be not simple. Oh wait, sorry, I had my Skinner wrong.
If you would like to save your place in line and have an agent call you back when it's your turn, press 1. Otherwise, continue to hold and a representative will be with you shortly.
Oh, this is Tuesday's Gone, I think. Stop the world, I want a fucking Wyler, you motherfucker.
Chuck FM!
Mind the gap.
Tell me, sir. If you wouldn't mind, please mind the gap. Thank you.
If you'd like to save your place in line and have an agent call you back when it's your turn.
Only if it'll be so sexy. Kira, what is this you're subjecting us all to?
It's one of our karaoke people I haven't played in a while.
Mike was very disappointed that it was not a certain karaoke gal.
It sounded like her at first.
And apologies to Mike that I started to call you Patrick.
Right.
It's winding down.
Oh boy. I mean, it still kind of sounds like Dave Matthews, though.
But in the background, is that like Ghostbusters video game? Weird. On the street.
I think it's Data East, yes. Ah, that gentleman just apprehended a Corona?
I don't know.
I'll just take a chug of this. Oh, we had a discussion, Kira, before the show started. Do you want to hear about it?
Okay.
Or should I shut up and we should make some pranfunkles?
No, we've made a good amount of calls.
And I wanted to bring this up. So on one of the fairly recent episodes, a couple of different things. We visited our karaoke gal's version of Roses by Outkast.
Mm-hmm.
And I had a question for Mike, and Mike, maybe you can answer this question right now live on the show.
Yes.
Do roses smell like boo-boo-boo, or do they smell like poo-poo-poo, as our karaoke gal suggested? Mike is our resident Outkast expert.
I believe the phrase is a boo-boo.
Boo?
Boo, boo, boo. With a B.
Okay.
Yes. In the song.
So that's the reinforcement. What is she doing now?
Hi!
It's Raining Man. This is an uh-oh situation.
You tell him why.
You tell him why.
Come on, girl, tell him.
Now listen up.
Humidity's rising. Barometer's getting low. According to all sources, the street's the place to go. Tonight, for the first time, at just about 10:30, for the first time in history, it's gonna start raining men. It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining men. Amen.
I'm gonna go out. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna let myself get absolutely soaking wet.
It's raining men. Hallelujah, it's raining.
Pranfunkles! How are we doing?
What?
And we're back.
It's a pencils and popcorn situation. Anyone ever looked at pencils?
Your call may be recorded. Please press 1 to speak with a live representative.
When you press 1 and get a live representative, give me in the card,
Thank you for calling Napoli. My name is Joao. How may I help you?
Hello.
Yes, thank you for calling Napoli. My name is Joao. How may I help you?
Yes, it's me, Hector. You've been calling me.
Yes, sir. How are you doing today? We're calling in regards to your recent inquiry about your regarding the PFAS. Want to see if you're still interested in going through the pre-qualification process?
Okay, amigo.
Okay, is that fine, sir?
Yes.
Okay. And
we're in Disneyland tonight.
Excuse me, sir.
I'm very happy, and I'm very happy. I just got out of Disneyland right now.
Okay, if you like, I can go ahead and schedule you a time back.
It's not right. No,
no
sir.
Sir.
No.
Okay, sir. Would you like to go through the pre-qualification process?
Several times. Yes.
Okay.
Please.
Okay, sir. So I'm just. Yes, sir. I'm listening.
That is correct.
Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and gather some basic information, take you through a pre-qualification process, ask you about the type of contact you may have had with the PFAS, as well as any injuries or medical conditions that may be related to that contact. Go ahead and provide me with your first name and spelling, sir.
My name is Hector.
Hector. Last name?
Gladstone.
Gladstone?
Yes.
I'm going to go ahead and repeat that back to you. Make sure I have everything spelled correctly. That is Hector, H as in Henry, E as in Echo, C as in Cat, T as in Tom, O as in Oscar, R as in Robert, Hector, last name Gladstone, G as in Goat, L as in Lima, A as in Alpha, D as in David, S as in Sam, T as in Tom, O as in Oscar, N as in Nancy, E as in Echo, correct?
You know, I'm just a human being with a heart.
Mr. Philip Hendry.
Hello,
yes.
Sir?
Yes.
Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, Mr. Gladstone, 1 second.
Do you have a Facebook page?
No, sir.
Do you have a roommate?
No, okay. Okay, Mr. Gladstone, I'm going to have to disconnect, sir.
But where's Ileana?
Okay, I'm afraid this is the wrong number, sir. You have a great day, sir. Thank you.
I'm afraid of it.
Dave. I have records.
Kira?
We'll have breakfast at Denny's.
Are you there?
Yeah. We're going to have hoons over my hammy.
Well, we're going to have hoons over my hammy.
That is correct.
What would... If you went to breakfast...
A whammy burger type of place?
No. If you went to Denny's with Hector and had breakfast, what would you get?
It's a malleable grunt munch situation.
So you're sitting down in the booth, Hector's across from you, and the waitress comes over, looks at you first, says, "What can I get for you?"
What I get for you? I'm Hector. You son of a bitch.
Jack in the Box?
No, Denny's.
Well, okay.
Brandfunkles will be right back after this commercial message.
A wine can be.
And now back to Brandfunkles.
Brandfunkles. Welcome back to the show.
Are we on the same page?
I don't know. Kira, you there?
Yeah, this is a hobo who claims to be... Yeah, and he claims to be the Grim Reaper.
Mike is listening on me. What are you doing, Mike?
It's a lovely recording you have there.
Welcome to your wireless carrier's voicemail system. Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice message system. At the tone, please record your message. When you are finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
We'll put your name in a hopper.
Master. Yeah!
Press 1 to save your message. Press 2 to listen to your message.
We'll put your name in the hopper.
Master. Yeah! Well, our own version of hell is one we created tonight.
Press 2.
Pat Robertson, the guy that announced all those sports events from Louisiana. Pat Robertson, here we go. It's a whack door situation where you're staying at Big Ed's hamburger stand in a certain area. Let's make a pranfuckle. Kira?
Norton LifeLock, I think Yeah, exactly. Call about, Jack can call about Noyton.
I'm not trying to make that.
No, it's already on there. My notes.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to take over.
Nah, because that's what I had as the notes for him to call about Noyton.
Noyton. Grab Munch. Devoice. That's a grant. Munch.
Thank you for calling Norton LifeLock. Your call will be recorded to ensure you receive the best service possible. Enrollment in Norton LifeLock service is easy. It takes just a few minutes. To enroll in Norton LifeLock or to learn more about enrolling in our services,
your call will be recorded to ensure the best possible service. Please wait while we connect you to the next available agent.
Talk to this agent.
Hi, thank you for calling about LifeLock and Norton Security Products. This is Ernell on a recorded line. How may I help you today? Hello? Hello, sir. Thank you for calling Norton LifeLock. This is Ernell on a recorded line. How may I help you today?
16-ounce shake.
Sorry, sir?
It's a 16-ounce shake.
What do you mean, sir? Are you signing up for a membership or identity protection, sir?
I am.
Okay, and what state do you live in? Shake. What state do you live in, sir?
It's a Benelson's Broadley situation.
We're talking about, sir, what state do you live in?
That's 16-ounce shake. Malcolm Jamal Warner.
Sir, we're talking about the address where you live in.
Yes.
The address where you live in.
The address where you live in. Stop pressing zero, you stupid motherfucker.
Sir, you're not signing up for a membership, sir. Stop calling us, sir, okay?
I like your voice. I wish you wouldn't hang up on me, you stupid motherfucker.
We're not tolerating these profanity words, and we capture your
phone. I'm tolerating you because I love your voice. I'm just loving it. McDonald's.
Oh, God, he's tracing it. You guys, he's tracing it. Stop, please.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to trace. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll stop.
That guy's tracing the call. Don't you know what's going on?
I'll shut up.
Do you know how much trouble we're going to get in for this?
I think I'm in trouble by Mr. Lindsay Buckingham.
No, they're tracing it.
I'm sorry.
We are so grounded.
Mr. Rain Wilson was also a contributor.
Mike, we're so grounded.
Mike, what do you think's going on here, Mike?
We're fucked.
Your kitties are fucking around.
Are you still there?
This gentleman doesn't like kittens. And he's a...
Mike, talk some sense into this guy, can you?
Excuse us while we kiss this guy.
Hello, sir? Are you
hello?
There?
Hello, ma'am. Are you signing up for the membership? I'm sorry, ma'am, but it seems that your friend is saying profanity word. I'm so sorry. We didn't tolerate that.
So you reported this, then?
Yeah, because if he's not signing up for a membership, I'm asking where the state where he located is.
Do you know how much trouble we're going to get in? Please don't report us. Please.
Okay, so are we signing up for a membership, sir? Ma'am, by the way? Sorry.
I don't know what they were doing, but I heard like a bunch of beeping and I thought you called the police.
We're signing up, ma'am. We're signing up.
Okay, and what state do you live in?
It's a Grayson's.
Hello, what state do you live in?
Macon, Georgia.
Okay, and we advertise in a lot of different places and always like to know how people hear about us. How did you hear about us?
My dick was hard.
Hello?
I've got three. And the mosquitoes keep coming back.
Hello, I'm so sorry, but are we still signing up with a membership?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, sir.
Teacher lady had some questions about that episode of Seinfeld.
Hello?
Hello, are we signing up for a membership?
It's yes, sir.
Wozenberries.
Okay, yes, sir. And by the way, like what I said, sir, we advertise in a lot of different places and always like to know how people hear about us. How did you hear about us?
I used to own a house that was probably, my bedroom was probably 100 to 125 foot away from a railroad track. And that train came through at 3:15 usually every morning. They blow the horn because there was an intersection next to my house out there. That would wake me up for the first month, probably. Then I got to where I didn't even hear it. You get immune to the sounds like that. Hello?
Hello, sir. We're talking about how did you hear about us,
yes.
Sir?
Yes, I'm asking about the product.
Yeah, I'll be more happy to discuss to you how the product works, but I want to clarify, how did you hear about us?
My wife told me about it.
Okay, and I don't need your email at this moment, but most of our plan require an email address. Which email address would you like to use, sir?
Well, it's Robert Picansworth at dinkandbodymario.memphistennessee.org. Can you hear it?
Say it one more time, sir.
Huh?
Mind the gap.
I'm sorry, sir. I don't think you did you mind the gap?
Are you with someone else? Are you okay with the other individual having an answer to your security questions and other sensitive information?
Mind I am.
The gap.
Yes, I love these people who are minding the gap with me. Mike?
I mind it.
Mike and Kira are okay with what I'm doing.
Yeah, I minded it. Go ahead.
Okay, thank you.
I think everybody in this needs to be minding the gap.
All the fellas.
Mind the gap.
What'd you say your name was?
Probably so.
Sir? Sir?
Mind you're asking about your emails.
Would you mind the gap?
Sir, I'm so sorry, sir, but are we still signing up for a membership, sir?
Absolutely.
So I'm asking about your email.
We might sign up for two. If.
Yes, I'm
asking
about your email.
If you mind.
If
you mind. Hold on.
Mind the gap.
There it is. So are you in?
Guys, don't make him mad. He'll start pressing buttons and we'll go to jail.
Look, you were gonna report us, right? Right?
Man,
I think the cops are already on the way. I think it's too
late.
When
you go into the cops, then you're gonna hang up on the cops.
We're gonna be grounded for like the whole summer.
When they're gonna ground us for the whole summer.
Alright.
Gabbing the door, gotta go.
See, there's some flashing lights coming this way, you guys. Fuck.
When you go, where am I gonna go?
Dude, I told you it was dumb to make prank calls.
Gabbing the door, gotta go.
Now we're fucked.
And now we're bugged.
Alright, somebody's coming up to the door.
Let's sign up.
I'm not gonna answer it.
When you come into my car, go.
I'm not gonna answer it, you guys. I think it's the cops.
Let's make some Pranfunkles.
Shh! We're gonna get put in jail. Thanks a lot, guy. You just ruined all our lives. Bye. He just wouldn't say anything.
What was that message?
What was he doing, like, pressing buttons really fast, trying to scare us like kids?
He had a Tom Skerritt situation. Mr. Tom Skerritt.
Like, I'm afraid I'm gonna report it. Beep, 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 beep. That's like the most 80s way to try to threaten a kid.
Filling station 246.
When you were a kid and you called somebody, did they ever, like, pretend, except for the here, lemme guy, did they ever, like, go, like, click, 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 like, I'm tracing your call?
Nah. Did you?
I had so many people tell me they were tracing it. I never believed them.
Here, why me?
Yeah, maybe it's a California thing.
Where you go, where you go, where you go.
Mike?
Yes?
What are you doing?
Living the dream. Remember the lady that was going to triangle trace her?
Kira?
Under a triangle situation.
Triangulate?
That almost happened. I think Kira stepped away. So.
Were we going to do that thing we were talking about?
Maybe. You think you're up for it?
Do you think I am?
I think you could be.
Seems like you're not.
It's a lot of moving parts.
When you come into my moving parts?
Should probably make a prank phone call.
Yeah, could do that too. would be a good time.
Let's see where they don't have the prank. Where these pranksters. They don't have pranksters here. Yeah, prank them out.
This is a business line, not for the pranks, okay?
Not for the prongs.
Not for the prongs.
Right on, buddy.
What do you think?
I think that's the way to go. You know?
We haven't spoken to the individuals on the other radio station?
I have not.
Should we do that?
Call them up.
Call them up!
Hey, smart mouth.
Call them up!
When your phone rings, answer it.
You want to sing with me? Robin, you want to sing with me? Who let the dogs out? Dun, 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 dun. It's so good loving somebody. When somebody loves you back, Robin, that's the fact.
Calling my phone, bitch. I don't know you. I'm about this money getting what I'ma do. Leave my phone alone, though. Call my shit. I don't give a fuck about none of you motherfucking bitches.
How y'all doing?
Good times.
You got a number we should call, Mike?
Well, I don't know. What do you think?
There's a lot of clicking.
Well, what do you got?
Homeboy is clicking a lot of things.
766. What are you waiting for? 1-900-438-9766. Just $3.99 per minute.
The service you're attempting to use has been restricted or is unavailable. Please contact customer care for assistance. Message ML402WI65.
No, it isn't.
Be dead down here.
She was.
Be dead down here. Come on. Your life is mine very soon.
What do you think?
Hmm.
Hey. Who is it?
I'm gonna dial a number here.
Okay, Ralph. She just told me that you're an asshole. Good night, Ralph.
Well, thanks for letting us know. You know what this is?
Clown Man!
I think that's Clown Man.
T6. No route exists to the dialed destination. Please try your call again later.
Yes, yes.
Let's make a Pran Funkle.
Yeah. You want to?
Yes.
Okay, prank call.
Yeah, and your boyfriend, or your man, or the guy who's right
guess
now.
Guess what? Guess what?
You guys fucking playing around with me on the phone? Guess what? Don't ever call me again, for real. I'm the wrong one, bitch.
And guess what?
I'm a businessman. That's what I do. I run a resale business, not a heroin business. I don't do that, baby. Sorry, you stupid bitch. I'm the wrong one, baby. I promise you.
Uh-huh. I got the wrong one, baby. Kira?
Whoa. I'll just assume this is an erroneous phone call.
Are you there, Kira?
California is shaped like a boot.
Excuse me?
The dick pics I've never even heard of. I don't even know what they are.
Let's call that dick pics guy.
Dick pics.
Dog in the morning.
Dick pics? Dick pics.
Let's call him.
Was like kind of like the old Kool-Aid candy or whatever. Dick pics.
Ready.
Thank you.
Pranfunkles, hello?
Live.
Are you trying to make a room reservation, sir?
Kira, are you there? It's a Borbles dynamic situation.
It is.
Cinnamon flavored stencils.
Yeah.
Right now at McDonald's, we've got a surprise. You can get a personal size pepperoni pizza. For just 99 cents. That's right, a personal size pepperoni pizza for just 99 cents with the purchase of any soft drink. But you better hurry, because after April 4th, this deal's gone.
Only 99 cents, this is a great offer. Didn't know I knew magic, did you? Hands are quicker than the eye.
At McDonald's today. See?
Mr. Howard Mandelinthon.
Okay, you ready for another number?
Should we make a Pranfunkle? God damn it.
Yeah, it's a person who went to a crisscross concert. They kept the straw from their soft drink they had in remembrance of the event, and they wear it behind their ear every day.
Voicemail of Joe Cobriner. Please leave your name, phone number, and a short message after the tone. Thank you.
Cobriner.
This is the voicemail of Joe Cobriner.
I don't know what's going on with the phone. That's what I'm telling you.
The tone. Thank you.
At the tone, please record your message. When you've finished recording, you may hang up or press 1 for more options.
But...
Oh, no. What happened? Oh, no. What happened?
Mind
the gap.
Yeah.
That was Mind the gap.
Come to Uncle Tom. Ow! Tight black kitten. Come here, you little shush. Quiet. Come. Ow! Dog in
If you're satisfied with the message, press 1. Message review.
Oh, no. What happened? Ah! Ah! Oh, no. What happened?
Mind.
Time to resign the gap.
Yeah.
Time to resign. Mind the gap.
Time to resign.
Come to Uncle Tom. Ow! Hi, buddy. Come here, you little shush. Quiet!
If you're satisfied with the message, press 1. To listen
to
the message.
How are we doing? Here we go. Mind the gap, Tabrizer.
Your call may be recorded for call quality assurance purposes.
Mind the gap.
Thank you for calling the ABA Law Group Camp Lejeune Justice Act helpline. Please hold for the next available representative.
Mind the gap.
Thank you for calling the Camp Lejeune helpline. This is Britt. How can I help you?
Hi, Burble Beep. My name is Tom Saltermeyer. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm pretty good. What's your name, ma'am?
I'm Britt. Are you calling to see if you qualify for a Camp Lejeune toxic water claim?
That is part of the objective, yes.
Okay. I'm sorry. You might hear my little one in the background. He's sick.
Ah, that's okay. That's okay.
Okay, and could you please spell your last name for me?
Saltermeyer, comma, E-R.
Okay. All right, and I have your phone number as...
It's an apple butter kind of situation, ma'am.
Okay. So were you at Camp Lejeune for at least 30 days?
Yes.
Okay, when were you at Camp Lejeune?
Well, there was a butter pecan, a Longston situation.
Sir? I'm going to let you go if you can't have a serious conversation with me, okay?
No, I'm having a serious conversation, ma'am. Can we please speak? It's a med abuse loop. Wilford Brimley kind of thing.
So when were you at Camp Lejeune?
At Tinsel's... situation. Robert.
Okay, sir. Since you can't answer my questions, I am going to let you go.
I did answer. I did answer. Is this Clown Man?
Hey, Alright, turn that off, please. Hello, ma'am? Hello?
Hello?
Hi, what's happening here?
That's a marvel.
A prank call, apparently.
Jimmy, who are you calling?
This is the Camp Lejeune Toxic Water Hotline.
Okay, I'm sorry. My son is playing around on the phone tonight.
I'm going into the gunner group.
All right, well, you have a good night.
I heard a baby or something, and it woke me up.
Yes, they're letting me work from home tonight. My son's sick.
Oh, God. Okay, so we're both not really in great shape tonight, I guess.
It's okay. It's all right, but you get some sleep.
I will. I hope your son does, too. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
It's a grunt much.
Quiet. Go to bed.
Well, it's been
I feel bad for her. She got her kid, you know.
She might have been the Clown Man. I don't
know. Probably was the voice actress for Clown Man, yeah.
Mike, what do you think?
It's a grunt munch.
Mm-hmm. I don't understand.
Let's make a pranfunkle.
Okay.
Let's go. Get another headset. Get another headset.
The handkerchief stealer.
When you come into my
Let's call that guy.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system. 8.
I will have your phone number be reported, so be ready, okay?
Is your phone number deal reported?
Get ready for a large potato salad.
Get ready.
Your call has been forwarded.
You what?
Man, nobody on these, like, home or cell phones wants to talk tonight.
Toby.
Oh, Toby. Maybe he wants to talk.
Toby.
Do what?
Let's call Toby.
Thank you for calling the Best Western Architecture.
Hello.
This is Bert.
Please leave your message for...
Hello.
I'll send my call back.
You would.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, I'm here. Hello?
Hello?
Hello, put your husband on the line.
Hi, we have a bit of a pencil situation. At Robert Consworth.
May I speak, please?
Speak?
Yes, there's a Gendelson that thinks that you're not a neat guy. Have you thought about that? There's a pimply gent. God damn it.
Have you heard?
Are you on drugs? Could you let me talk, please? Hello? Hey, bitch, what's up?
Call him back. He's doing his usual routine.
Hello?
Call back.
Hello? Hello?
Marbles!
I can't hear you. You're cutting out.
Marbles?
Alright, he's too boring.
I'm being very nice to you.
What's the name of that soundboard?
Carly?
Oh, Quality Carly?
Carly.
Let's see. I do have that board. I thought I didn't. Person who wore out their boxing gloves and is instead using 3 pairs of oven mitts.
Popcorn. Michael has sent you this message.
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 8.
You motherfucking bitch.
See, daddy, older man, if you like, I'm into the kinky, the taboo. Some fetishes. Something happened to me yesterday when I was working on a job.
To an automatic voice message system. 80.
Not no, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, who is on telephone? What is happening? Move to the jacuzzi. Ooh, that booty. Smack it up, flip it, rub it down. Oh, no.
If you are satisfied with your message, press 1. To listen to your message, press 2. To erase, message review.
Ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Hello.
Hello, who is on
Move through the jacuzzi. Ooh, that booty. Smack it up, flip it, tap it down. No, oh, no.
If you are satisfied with your message, press 1. To listen to your message, press 2 to erase.
No. Hello.
Fran Funkles will be right back after this commercial message.
Honey, what's a six-letter word for money?
Eureka!
Eureka! The word for money.
Years ago, I started running and eating breakfast with grape nut cereal. It's a good way to get complex carbohydrates. Since then, I've found there's so much more to it. It's helped keep me going through hundreds of mornings. That hearty taste. And there's no fat in grape nuts. It's just this natural energy source that keeps coming through for me. That's why it's the one I'll always keep going with. Try it. You'll see.
Breakfast with Post Grape Nuts helps keep you going strong all morning long.
And now back to Fran Funkles.
You got all that? Want another one? I'm ready.
Cody?
Yeah?
You see what's going on here? What's happening?
I guess Omegle is broken. That sucks. About chat roulette. Alright, well, we gotta skedaddle anyway.
Yeah. Probably a good time to wrap it up.
Anything else, Mike?
No, I think that's about it. Happy 4th. See y'all tomorrow.
Alright. Yeah, bonus show tomorrow. Around the same time, I guess, you guys?
Yeah.
Okay.
Probably so.
I love you a lot. Like to fancy you.
See you, bye.
Mind the gap.